big day has arrived. We are going to convert this quarter of a log into this. So let's get going.
The first step is to figure out what size timber you can actually get out of a section of log. In this case, I believe I can get a 3x5. I can't quite get a 3x6. With that in mind, I go ahead and mark a level line as a reference using my newly built 18th century style level. And then I use a square to establish vertical lines off of that level line. I go over 3 inches and mark another vertical line. This establishes the thickness of the timber. I now see how much waste I really need to remove off the sides. To begin, I strip the bark off the top of the log. Using my hatchet, I cut tiny little grooves in the top of the vertical lines. This is for the string line to rest in. I then tack nails into each vertical line on both ends and run a chalk line from end to end. This establishes the thickness of the timber all the way down. And now I begin removing the excess material from off the timber. There are quite a few different ways one can do this, depending on individual preference and tool availability. In this demonstration, I'm going to show 2 or 3 different methods, so stick around. So the excess wood is starting to split off, finally, but it's a long, delicate process and takes a great deal of care. I drive down the hatchet into a line just to break the wood fibers. And once I get far enough down where it's not going to split into the useful timber, I can start driving wedges in, and this will complete the split. Once the bulk material is removed, I can take my axe and start cleaning up. Further down the line, I'm cutting notches into the thicker part of the slab to come off. And this ensures that when I cut off the excess, it doesn't take any of the useful timber with it. With good deep notches cut into the log, I can then just split the waste off. These notches are cut in a V pattern, almost but not quite down to the chalk line. With all the notches in place, I can now just take the hammer and wedge and split off the excess. And then, as before, I just go through and clean everything up with an axe and dress it up. My objective is to get it down to within 3/8 to a quarter of an inch of the chalk line. dressing up is a very difficult work for a double beveled axe. Not impossible, but far more difficult than it is for a single beveled broad axe. And now I establish the top of the timber. And I run a chalk line down both sides. And this will give me a level plane to work on. I go down along the top of the timber and make shallow cuts. And this will ensure that I don't rip out more material than necessary. I may have to make two passes on this particular surface to make it perfectly flat. And now the delicate process of shaving the top of the timber. This can be done with a broad axe, a felling axe, or a foot axe. In this case, I'm just using my regular felling axe, and it's doing pretty well. For thicker material, I flip the log on its side, stand up, and just chop it out with an axe. Then I flip the log back up and dress it up as before. And so we have a useful timber. This could easily be used for framing out an outbuilding, such as a barn or a shed. But for finer work, it can be further refined with a draw knife or a single beveled broad axe or even a foot axe. For an exposed timber, what type of surface would you prefer? Would you prefer very refined, very smooth, or something more rustic? Let us know in the comments below. And make sure you check out these other awesome videos, including how to build an 18th century level for yourself. Thank you for watching.